Hey there, fellow astronomers. If you've watched any of my videos over the last couple of years, hopefully you know that the theme of this channel is science is people, that astronomy and being an astronomer is about being part of a community. And that's what entrances me about the AAAS meetings every year, the big winter meetings especially. That is the biggest form of community within the American astronomical community that comes together to celebrate and to share and to collaborate. So there's an impetus for the community, i.e. you and me, the members who are going to this meeting and sharing our science. It's on us to participate and to be part of making this meeting happen. But just as important, and something that I think doesn't get talked about or appreciated enough, is the hardworking people who make these meetings happen. So I am really grateful and really excited to share with you a short chat that I had with Debbie Kowalski, who is one of the main people who makes the meetings happen. And I hope what really comes through is that Debbie represents one of a ton of people who've been working tirelessly, super hard for months to make this event happen. So with all that in mind, here's a chat with Debbie Kowalski from the AAAS.
Hi, I'm Debbie Kowalski, and I'm the Director of Exhibits and Development at the American Astronomical Society. And I've been working with the AAS since the early 90s.
Is this the most difficult meeting you've ever, you've been involved in a lot of winter meetings, and I know this is like the big event you guys do every year, although you do a lot of things, it's not just the winter meeting, but is this the most difficult?
I wouldn't say it's the most difficult. It's every meeting has its own challenges. This year has definitely been a challenge. I think the last summer meeting was difficult because we were completely thrown into the unknown and we had to very quickly figure out what to do. We almost canceled and I said, No, don't do that. A group of us said, we're going to find a solution. And we researched really quickly for some solutions that were out there. There were not a lot. We came across a few. We found a platform called VFairs. Mm-hmm. We were really impressed with it. They were using it for many solutions for job fairs, career fairs, college fairs, that kind of thing. And they had just come into the virtual meetings, conferences.
Yeah. And it's something. It's like a lifeline, right? Like, yeah. Instead of just canceling.
Yeah, so great. It was great for June, and that was really good. And over the summer, we did the DDA meeting. But we learned a lot from these three meetings. People were concerned about the networking wasn't happening. People weren't networking as much. The exhibitors didn't feel like they were being visited.
I'm always so impressed with like how put together the exhibitor hall is, like how immersive and entertaining. I've been really enjoying the advancements of like, I like the live stage that we have for like the iPoster Plus last year. I thought that was really cool. I think there's even more things we could do, you know, to make that space more engaging. And so that's my favorite space in the whole meeting. And so it's the piece that I'm going to miss the most is like it's the wander and chat. And so I'm really curious, how do you envision, you know, 5 days of this meeting? How do you envision people like me getting my wander on and my chat? How am I going to interact with these booths? What's that experience going to be like?
Sure. So what we've done is we have given the exhibitors every tool they could possibly want to use to engage.
Sure.
Now it's a matter of people have to come. You can chat with them over just a text chat in a group. You can do one-on-one chatting, and then you can go into a video chat if you want with them.
Is that all through VFairs?
That's all through VFairs, and that's their proprietary system.
Okay.
And that's something we had in the summer. But one of the other things that we've given every single exhibitor has a Zoom room, their own Zoom account. Right. So it's always live. Their staff will be in there. Now, they're not there from 11 in the morning until 6:30 at night. They're going to be designated exhibit hall hours.
Okay.
So look at the block schedule, figure out when those are. They're in the afternoons. And everybody, those are the times to go to the exhibit hall and you're going to have, they're going to be fully staffed then. So you can go into the Zoom rooms. They're doing demos. They have breakout rooms within their Zoom rooms. They're doing meet and greets. They have VIP sections. So there'll be a daily schedule of all the activities that are going on in all the booths. Some of the publishers have discounts, some there are contests going on. Startorialist is giving every single exhibitor a $25 gift card as a prize. So every exhibitor is going to be doing some sort of contest.
Can I break that news on this? Can I share
absolutely.
That? Absolutely. Okay.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, shout out Sartorialist. That's great.
And so we're really trying to increase the traffic. So you will be able to go into these Zoom rooms and have conversations with the exhibitors, just like you would if you were on the floor. And then we also have Slack. The Slack channels are there so that there's conversation going on, whether you've left a session and you want more questions to the speakers, or you have questions to the exhibitors, or the exhibitors are posing questions to the attendees. So it's a great way to do some of that networking and talking and those just random conversations that people would have as they're walking out of a session to continue the topic that was going on.
Now, I know we're trying to bend Slack to our will. Like, it's not the perfect tool for this scenario. It's right. I mean, like, we're trying to use tools that we have and that are available and that people can download on all the different platforms that they're using. But it strikes me as like an actual real opportunity that, like, now there's a chat room that I know we had the app before and there was some chat capabilities, but it was pretty underused, the chat capabilities of the app. Now we've got a platform that almost everybody is familiar with or has seen or heard. And it has, like, you know, a quarter of the entire AWS membership or whatever is like in that Slack channel. Is that something that the AWS is considering continuing moving forward back into the physical meetings, hopefully next year? Can we expect this Slack channel to stay persistent? Like, it's not just going to disappear in a month and all those conversations and those ideas that sparked aren't just going to evaporate?
Well, we are definitely going to be taking a lot of the things that we've learned from the virtual platforms and integrating them into the face-to-face meetings. And we're also going to take some of the things that we've done in the virtual world and do them on off times. Maybe we'll have workshops. The reason we do so much at the winter meeting is because, we've got captive audience. So let's do workshops. Let's do employment stuff. Let's do the career center. Let's do the grad school fair.
We're
trying to do everything, and people are just always overwhelmed.
Yeah.
And even at this virtual meeting, we have 28 parallel sessions.
Wow.
The good thing is, though, everything's recorded.
Yes.
So you don't have to say, oh my gosh, I want to go to the session over here. It's okay. You can still see the recorded talks. You can still participate in the conversation over Slack. Mm-hmm. See the questions that were asked and continue to ask questions to the author. So the answer to your question is yes. We will take some of the components, whether it's Slack or some other chat tool. We will definitely do that. But of course, everything comes with a cost.
Yeah, right.
So, you know, people love the idea that we'll be able to have a face-to-face meeting and there could be a virtual component of it.
I think the idea of recording it and making like a chat platform available seems really cool. I'm really excited about that, about trying to think about how the Hack Day, for example, integrates into the in-person meeting when it has a persistent Slack channel or whatever for the whole week and maybe for the whole year.
Yeah, I agree.
I
think it's great. We can have conversations about while we're planning the meeting.
Yeah.
As things are going on, if we were all on Slack. So
yeah.
I agree with you. I think it's great. We'll take some of those ideas and keep them going.
To go back for a minute, go back to the exhibitor hall. One of the other things that I think I mentioned this on the phone to you that really strikes me about what I love about AWS and the exhibitor hall. I've been to a few other meetings and like some comic book conventions and things. And the exhibitor hall in a lot of other meetings is really focused on selling things. And like people do sell stuff. We have Sartorialist sells clothes. Publishers sell books, but that's about it. There's not that much sales. And I'm always struck at our meetings how, you know, it's the observatories who are giving out pens and mouse pads. And I mean, here's my NASA mouse pad from 2 years ago that's still sitting right here. That's something that I really appreciate. And I didn't appreciate it as much until I went to this other meeting that was all buy our stuff, buy our books, buy our whatevers. And it's something that, you know, it makes me doubly want to get people to engage with the exhibitors because they're not in it to sell you t-shirts. You know, I'm really glad to have somebody from the AAS, have you to talk to. And I really appreciate that point that these exhibitors, these aren't just salespeople, that these are part of our community.
I appreciate you saying all that because one of the things that is so important is that they're scientists and they're scientists who want to talk to the scientists and ask them, what do you need? What do you need from our observatory? What do you need from our lab? What do you need from our missions? What can we do for you? They're there to serve our community. So please take the time to go in and have these conversations with them. Mm-hmm. Go to their town halls. There are 71 exhibitor webinars. This is something new. Wow. We started in June. I wanted to give the exhibitors another venue to talk. And what's really interesting, especially for undergrads and graduate students who are listening to this, the exhibitor webinars are a higher level talk.
So what's the distinction between a webinar and a town hall? Because I know some of the booths are going to have, you know, like NASA is going to have various town halls and NSF will have a town hall. So,
well, okay. So the town halls are agency wide. Talk about everything that's going on at NASA, right, in astrophysics. NSF is the same idea. They'd be talking about AST division. The exhibitor webinars, they have come up with specific topics. It could be careers at ORA, how to write a proposal for James Webb Telescope. That might be one of the ones that Space Telescope decided that they want to hold. Mm-hmm. So in the itinerary planner, the schedule, you can browse through them and you'll see that they're listed there. They're only half an hour long. They're 15-minute presentations. And then there's 15 minutes Q&A. And they're supposed to be, you know, more informal.
Can I ask about swag? Yeah. Is there any thoughts for, I mean, we can't just mail everybody their little bag of stuff, I guess. Is there anybody doing swag? Like, that's something else that I guess, you know, I'm not going to get my mouse pad this year.
Well, if you registered before December 1st, you actually got the NASA calendar mailed to you. Some of the exhibitors have digital swag.
Okay.
So, you know, ebooks or digital music, or I know some of them have Zoom backgrounds, things like that. Some of them are actually arranging and mailing swag to people. Mm-hmm. So you definitely want to go and get contests, you know, enter whatever they're doing. Some of them have giveaways, gift cards, things like that. So you definitely want to stop by. So that's how they're handling swag this go round. One of the events that first events that we're going to be hosting is the graduate school fair.
Right. Yes. I want to talk about that for sure, because that's usually an event that I go and have to talk for 2 hours in front of all these people. And it's such a rushed thing. But I noticed you guys have a longer fair this year.
Yeah, we do have a longer fair. And we're actually, this is one of the events that we are actually considering doing virtually moving forward and doing it multiple times in the year. We have 42 graduate schools and REU programs represented.
That's great.
And the reps will be there. You can make appointments to meet with them for that Sunday or any time during the week. They also have the video chatting capabilities and applications and docs and videos and everything are in their booth.
Well, this goes back to, I think, what the one of the hidden benefits of having the Slack, right, is that now if you run into somebody quickly at the grad school fair, then you can interact for the rest of the week. You can have that iPoster chat. And then as the faculty who are looking for new students and trying to recruit, I don't have to rely on that one scrap of paper that might have gotten passed around, people have written their names on it to express interest. I've got that chat history right on the Slack. What are your hopes? What is going to be a success for you? How are you going to judge this as a success versus like, oh, we really missed it? What do you think is going to be the thing that's going to give you satisfaction?
I think I will be satisfied if I hear from the exhibitors that people came and visited them and talked to them. I don't want to hear that 2,000 people came by their booth. I want to hear that they had, you know, 200 people came by and they had good questions, they have good leads, they're going to follow up with them, and new collaborations were formed.
Okay, people, there you go. Don't let Debbie down. Go visit. This is all she wants, is just go to the booths and have good conversations. That's all this is about. Go do it.
It really is. I mean, you know, they're there for you. You know, even our publishers, they're not there to sell books. They're there to find authors. ADS is there. They want to teach you how to use their tools.
Yeah.
They want, you know, they're there to be there for the community. So take advantage of them while you have a shot.
That is a great sentiment. That's what this meeting is supposed to be about, right? It's about the community. So
thank you very much. It was good to talk to you.
See you soon.